intersection Q, intersection S. P intersection Q, intersection S, which is equal to, already know the element of set P intersection Q, that is 2, 5, 9. Then intersection with the set S. Okay. Now we can combine. Otherwise, we'll once again write the element of set P intersection Q. Intersection element of set S 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. Now what is the answer? What's the common element? 2 is common and 5 is common. That's all. Therefore, the answer is 2, 5. P intersection Q, intersection S, which is equal to 2, 5. Copy these two subdivisions. Exercise number 1.4, first one, first two submissions. Complete the two submissions. Just this application of union and intersection. Yeah, union and intersection of the two sets. Oh, sorry, three sets. Okay, complete the first two submissions. Later, we'll move on to the third and fourth submission. Yeah, P intersection Q, and you can identify P intersection Q, intersection S. Just encircle the elements 2, 5. 2, 5 only is common for between the set P intersection Q and S. Student, understand the difference between the problems. Okay. Just one wait. The board is clearing. Just one wait. Now I think it's okay. It is 1, okay, just I'll read the element of set P. 1, 2, 5, 7, 9 and element of set Q. Then element of set Q. 2, 3, 5, 9, 11. Just I'll read out the element of set P. 1, 2, 5, 7, 9 and element of set Q. 2, 3, 5, 9, 11. I think the top line only is clearing. Okay. Now it is okay. Write down the elements only. Write down the element of set P and Q. Write down the element of set P and Q. I think now it is clear. What is the first line? Now it is clear. Look at the first line. Now it is clear. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Complete the first two subdivision. And next we'll move on to the third subdivision. Third subdivision is also its intersection between the three sets. Q intersection S intersection R. I think have you all received your timetable for your cycle test? Okay. Follow up the cycle test timetable and you can, the portion also is sent by ma'am. You can refer the Google Classroom. Regarding your cycle test or homework, everything you must refer your Google Classroom. Okay, the information shared only through Google Classroom. Is it clear? Then you can go through the portion. What is the portion they will given for the cycle test? Whatever they will given, just you can go through and today onwards you can start revise for your cycle test. Because next week onwards your cycle test is done. At the maximum tomorrow. Once you have completed your homework, you can upload your homework in the Google form. Okay. The form is sent in the Google Classroom. Refer the thing and you can upload your homework in the Google form. Only in the Google form. Refer your homework schedule. Okay. That homework schedule, ma'am will share in the Google Classroom. வீக்லி 3 டேஸ் ஒன்லி மேக்ஸ் ஹோம் ஒர்க் மண்டே வெனஸ்டே அண்ட் ஃப்ரைடே. ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட் தேர்ட் சப்டிவிஷன் கியூ இன்டர்செக்ஷன் எஸ் எஸ் இன்டர்செக்ஷன் ஆர். எஸ் எவ்ரிபடி எவ்ரிஒன் கம்ப்ளீட்டட் திஸ் டூ சப்டிவிஷன்ஸ்? எனிபடி வாண்ட்ஸ் டைம் டு கம்ப்ளீட் அ ப்ராப்ளம்? Okay, next third subdivision, subdivision number 3. What does the third subdivision mean? We will given the third subdivision as Q intersection S intersection R, which means you want to identify intersection between the set Q and S. Q intersection S. Okay, look at the set Q and S. What are the common element? 2, 3, 5. Okay, therefore the common element are 2, 3, 5. Okay, either I'll write the direct element, otherwise once again you can write the element of set Q intersection element of set S, then you can identify or to encircle the common element to write the element of set Q intersection S. Next is Q intersection S intersection R. Yeah, so this one only just directly write the element of set Q intersection S and intersection R, the element of set R, 3, 4, 5, 7, 9. Now what is the common element? 3 and 5 is the common element. 3, 5 is the answer. That Q intersection S intersection R equal to 3, 5. Next, the fourth solution. The last subdivision. Oh, sorry, there is only 3 subdivision. I'm sorry. Okay, you can complete this problem. There are 3 subdivision in this first numerator. Complete the third subdivision. Those they are finished now. I'll move on to the second problem. Copy the second problem question. Just you can check the commutative property of union and intersection of the set. They will define a set P and set Q. Like set P is equal to X such that X is a real number between 2 and 7. And Q is equal to X such that X is an irrational number between 2 and 7. Yeah, write the problem. Once I finish me, we'll move on to the second problem. Go through the second problem fully. Just you can check the commutative property of union and intersection of the two sets, set P and Q. Set P is consist of a real number between 2 and 7, and set Q is consist of an irrational number between 2 and 7. Okay, the real number and irrational number between 2 and 7. Okay, next second problem, question number 2. First, you can observe the two sets. It's a finite set or infinite set? Real number between 2 and 7. It is a finite set or infinite set? An irrational number between 2 and 7. It is a finite set or infinite set? First, answer the question whether the given set is a finite or infinite set. First, you can identify the difference. Whether it is a finite set or infinite set. That first one, they will given the element of set P. X such that X is a real number. A real number between 2 and 7. Between 2 and 7. Between 2 and 7. And next set Q, the element of set Q, X such that X is an irrational number irrational number. Number between 2 and 7. Now observe the two sets. The two sets are finite set or infinite set. Now that real number between the two number, we have infinite number of real number. That's why both the sets are infinite set, not a finite set. Listen carefully. In between two number, we have infinite number of real number. Okay. In between two number, for example, 1 to 2, we have infinite number of real number. The same idea for irrational number. Okay. In between the two number, we have infinite number of irrational number. Okay. For set P and set Q, both the sets are infinite sets. Okay. First, we'll observe both the sets. Both the sets are finite or infinite. Now, here, both the sets are infinite sets. Okay. What is the idea about irrational and real number? First is irrational. Next one is the real number. Actually, know about the number system. Draw a number system. This is natural number. Next one is whole number. And next one is integer. And next one is rational number. A rational number, that is Q. And next, irrational number. Irrational number, you can call it as Q plus. Next, irrational number. And next one is a real number. Next one is a real number. Natural number, whole number, integer, rational, irrational, real number. Okay. Natural number, whole number, integer, rational number, irrational number, and real number. Okay. Natural number, whole number, integer, rational, irrational, and real number. Now we can observe the given problem, the numbers between 2 to 7. Okay. That is a real number. Real number also is infinite set, and second one is set Q, it's the irrational number. Between 2 and 7, that is also infinite set. Okay, here. Set P is a real number set. P is a real number set. And set Q is an irrational number set. Irrational number set. Set P is the real number set and set Q is the irrational number set. Okay, listen carefully, students. Set P is the real number set and set Q is the irrational number set. Irrational number set. Okay. And look at the diagram. Look at the diagram. Natural number, next to whole number, integer, rational number, irrational number, next to real number. Okay. Irrational, next only real number. The real number is the whole, okay, the bigger one. The real number is the bigger one. Okay, inside the real number only, the rational number will come, which means we can denote it by set notation. Yeah. Irrational number is a subset of a real number. Is it correct? Because that irrational number is inside a real number. That is inside. For example, grade 9 students are inside that orchard. Okay, it belongs to orchard school. Yeah, you are belongs to that orchard school, grade 1 or a senior KG, a junior KG, okay, till grade 12. Everything is belongs to that orchard school, that category only. That's why the real number, this is a real number is the, okay, the real number is the bigger one, and the irrational number, okay, irrational number is inside real number. Then you can denote it by the set notation, in symbol notation. Therefore, Q is a subset of P. Yeah, Q is a subset of P. Okay, Q is a subset of P. Now, I can identify the commutative property of union. Commutative property of union. Using this idea, that Q is a subset of P. Using this idea, commutative property of union. Commutative property of union. And what will be happen? Then P union Q is equal to Q union P. What's the result will come? Okay. What result will come? That set P will come because it's the bigger set. For union, join everything. Therefore, the answer P. Next, commutative property of intersection. The commutative property of intersection. Commutative property for intersection. You don't write of union, that commutative property for union, that is enough. Only write as union or intersection. That commutative property for union, and this one is commutative property for intersection. P intersection Q equal to Q intersection P, which is equal to common. What's the common? The smallest set is the common. That Q is the common. Therefore, the answer is Q. That's all. This is only the solution for the second problem. Yeah, we'll write as that P union Q, which is equal to Q union P is equal to P, and P intersection Q, which is equal to Q intersection P is equal to Q. That's the solution of the second problem. You can copy. For this one, it's a rough diagram only. For your understanding, just you can draw the diagram. Natural number, whole number, integer, rational, irrational, and real number. This is Q and Q plus. I think that's one, right? I'll write with a bigger symbol. The symbol alone, I'll write bigger letter. That is N, and this is whole number, and this is integer I, and this is rational number Q, and this is irrational number Q plus, and this is a real number. This is a real number. Yeah, this alone you can draw in a rough diagram. That is for your understanding. Then only you can do the solution for this problem easily. Complete now. So complete this problem fully. This is only the idea for the second problem. Listen, student, this is not a finite set. Okay, this is not a finite set. Your answer is not also not a finite set. It's, everything is belongs to an infinite set idea. Sorry. Here we'll check the commutative property of union and commutative property for intersection. So solution for the second problem. I'm sorry, I made a mistake. That integers is it? Yeah, thank you. Thank you, student. That integer symbol is Z. Okay, for rational number, they'll use the notation as Q. For real number only, they'll use the notation as R. Okay. For natural whole number, and all, they'll use the first letter. But the remaining everything, just the notation will be changed. For integers, Z, and rational number is Q. Instead of R, they'll use the notation as Q. Yeah, here the problem is involving with the infinite set. Yeah, that's why we'll do the problem with the infinite sets only. It is not a finite set. Because up to the previous problem, everything is related with only finite set, but this one is related with the infinite set. You complete this problem fully. Is anybody having any doubt regarding the commutative property and the associative property? Actually, for the first problem, just you can observe that to identify that P union Q union R and P intersection Q intersection R. Yeah, that is also is related to associative property, but only the one half of the associative property will complete it for the first one. For the next problem, third problem, then we'll discuss that associative property of union, and the fourth problem, associative property of intersection of set. And fifth problem also the associative property of intersection of set. Okay, 3, 4, 5 is related with associative property. Okay, this is only the commutative property, and you can go through the example problem in your textbook also. The commutative property for the union of set and intersection of the set. The property alone you can go through because the examination didn't given the A union B or B union A. They will simply ask the problem like verify the commutative property. Okay, that verify the commutative property, which means the commutative property for union or intersection. So both the things you can verify. So they will ask only simple questions. Can you only answer properly? Okay, students, anybody having any doubts, you can ask your doubts. And this is only the idea for the commutative property for union and intersection for the set. But here it is the infinite set. Okay, the infinite set. That alone you can go through clearly. Because for finite sets, nah, definitely the answer will come. For example, P is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. And Q is equal to 2 and 4. Nah? What is the union? 1, 2, 3, 4. Intersection of 2 and 4 is the common. But here it is an infinite set. That's why you will write the answer in general. Okay, this is the generalized form. Okay, thank you, students. We'll meet on tomorrow's session. Thank you.